Hello, my name is Todd Klingler, and I'm the webmaster of a site called showandtell-graphics.com, and today we'll be using Photoshop to create a planet. I have a document open that is 600 by 435 pixels, and the first thing we're going to do is create a nice starry background for our planet. We'll start by clicking Edit, Fill with Black. Then we'll go Filter, Noise, Add Noise. Make sure the Gaussian and Monochromatic is clicked. We'll be between 20 and 25%. Click OK. And we'll go Image, Adjustments, Levels. This little slider here, you'll want to slide it down until you get the starry effect that you're looking for. We'll go with that. Click OK. Next, we'll want to create a new layer for our planet. We'll click the New Layer button right here. And we'll name that planet. P-L-A-N-E-T. Now we'll choose the elliptical marquee tool. Hold the Shift key down to constrain the proportions to a perfect circle. Make it nice and big. We're going to create this real big at first because we're going to fill it with a pattern. And typically pattern details are a little bit large, and it might look a little bit unnatural to have these large patterns for our planet. So we'll make it big, and then we'll reduce it down to make it look a little more natural. Okay, now we're going to want to fill it. So we're going to go Edit, Fill, drop down to Pattern. We're looking for a pattern card called Rock Wall, which is a pattern that's preloaded with Photoshop. If you don't see it, you'll need to come down here and go down to Rock Patterns. Click OK. And it should be right here. Then click OK. And there you have that fill. Next, we're going to want to go Filter, Distort, Spherize. You want the amount at 100% and Mode Normal. Say OK. And then hit Control D to deselect it and get rid of all these dancing ants. Okay, now that we have that done, we need to reduce the size of this planet. We'll go Edit, Transform, Scale. Hold the Shift key down, and that will keep our circle a nice circle. Grab one of these outside corners and drag it in until it's the size that you want it. And then let go of the mouse button, and then click Enter. As you can see, by reducing this, the details of the pattern got smaller, and it looks a little more planety to me anyway. So go ahead and move the planet over here. Click the move key here, and we'll put it somewhere over there. Next thing you want to do is duplicate this layer. So we'll come over here to the planet layer, right click, and click Duplicate Layer. Click OK. Okay, let's come down here to this middle layer now. We're going to add a little glow to this middle layer, so come down here to the Blending Options button down here. Click Blending Options. Go to Outer Glow. And bring this size up a little bit. We just want a little bit of glow around it. That looks good. Say OK. And now we need to add a little shadow to it. So we'll create a new layer. Make sure it's on top here. We'll call this layer Shadow. We're going to use the Pen tool to do this. So click on the Pen tool over here. let's say we're going to click outside the planet here, and the reason is because we're going to blur it out, and it will kind of meld into the planet better if we start on the outside. So we'll click here, and then click over here. Don't go too far. You don't want to go more than 90 degrees, because if we go more than 90 degrees, the pen tool can't create a even radius. So we'll click out here about the same distance out, pull it out, create a circle. Doesn't have to be perfect for this particular use, so don't worry if it's not a perfect radius. Then we're going to hold the Alt key down and click on this handle, which will let us continue on with what we're doing here. Click here, create another radius, Alt click right here, come over here, click, create another radius, Alt click again, come back and finish it, and create a little crescent. Something like that. So we've created this path with the pen tool. Now we need to change it to a selection. So we do that by clicking on the Paths tab, and then coming down and clicking on this button right here, which will change it to a selection and gives us our dancing ants. And then we're going to fill that with black. Edit. Fill. Black. Click OK. Then you'll want to deselect that by hitting Control D. Come back to our layers over here. There's our layer that we created. Now, with this layer highlighted, we want to go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. And you'll have to kind of slide this around until you get the blur you're looking for. Let's see, it's got to kind of play with it a little bit. Once you get it, click OK. And you might need to move it a little bit. So you can move it around. I like to kind of move around the backside so the glow around the bottom half doesn't show. Oh, that gives a nice effect. And there you have it. If you enjoyed this video, come on back to my site, showandtell-graphics.com. Have a good day.